Ladies and gentlemen, I give you Big Fish.
Story boy and any fish. My family's gonna starve.
Well, the fish will sleep.
Oh,
she showed me that night in the swamp. The three of us went looking for him. Just three teenage boys on a dare. I didn't know she would change my life forever.
Time. looking for you. Though you were there, your mother too. Except I didn't know her yet. She was just a girl with red hair.
You better find that girl, but it won't be easy. Where Will proposed to me.
family.
So before we get to dinner, we have a couple of
Yes, good evening. My name is Edward Bloom, and on behalf of me and my wife, Sandra, she's a gorgeous one right there. It's a pleasure to welcome y'all to Alabama. Cheers.
Cheers.
Now, Will told me I was not allowed to give a toast. You'll notice there is no glass in my hand. Now, by technicality, he says. Now, Will thinks I talk too much. But I would have loved to have had a talk with a father. See, my own daddy, he was a farmer. Lucky to get four words out of him. One day I heard him out in the field just blathering and blathering. He said he couldn't get a word in between me and my mom. Boom. The corn was all ears. And on the topic of fatherhood, I have an announcement. After careful consideration, I have decided to become a grandfather. Now, I am sworn to secrecy, but I've been told my ambitions may be fulfilled sooner than I dare hope.
Okay, it's time to catch the bouquet. Ladies, follow me.
There are a thousand things that could go wrong. It's too early.
Oh, they won't. Why are you such a pessimist?
I'm a realist, Dad. And yes, it's good news, but it's our news. Why do you have to make everything about you?
I'm sorry.
I get carried away.
No, you always get carried away, and I'm sick of it.
Oh, I'm sick of you treating me like a child. What kind of son is
the son whose father does this?
I'll grow up. Bro.
I did. You weren't there. You were never there.
I was building a business.
You were running away.
Oh, from what? From you?
From reality. All I ever got from you were a bunch of crazy stories about how awesome you are. And I'm sorry, Dad. It's not the man I see.
Maybe you never bothered looking.
Stop it! Both of you! Before you say something you can't take back.
I'm done.
So am I.
I need to tell Will. We should have never heard this from him.
Fine.
I'll get dressed.
I'll meet you outside.
Well, we're going to have a son.
I know.
Anyone think Edward Bloom's
I'm so sorry. What can I do? I want to help.
I'm just glad you know. Families shouldn't have secrets.
Mom, have you and Dad talked about money?
We have plenty of money.
Well, is the house paid off?
Years ago. The day we sent in the last check, we had champagne. Your father, he opened it with a sword. There was glass in the carpet for weeks.
Well, Mom, you wouldn't mind if I took a look through the mortgage, the insurance. I'm worried about you. But what's going to happen? We need to keep a roof over your head.
I'm not worried about the house. I'm not worried about me. I'm worried about you.
Mom, I'm fine. I'll be fine.
Oh, I'm fine. You sound like your father. You two are the most stubborn men in the world. It is my turn to love you both. There are two men in my life. Him and you. There are two
while I'm here. small, the phone book
was the Yellow Page.
And our town was so small, the zip code was a fraction. And our town was so small, we only had three jokes.
But I'll tell you, the best part about growing up in a small town like Ashton, a boy with ambition can be a pretty big deal.
Just like I thought,
The only kind of giant you are is a giant coward.
I will smash your bones and eat you for dinner.
Oh, well, you'll still be hungry. I'm more than an appetizer size.
Get out of my grave!
No! I come up here to talk to you.
I don't want to talk. I just want to be alone.
Oh, bull crap. You are alone, so you only pretend it's what you want. You're under all those dead animals and dead threats. I see a guy who might need a friend.
You don't know me.
See, up until now, I've been the biggest thing in Ashton. You've shown up to remind me. There's something bigger out there.
So go.
Come on. Look. This town is too small for you, and it's too small for a man of my ambition.
When's the last time you left this cave?
I'm agoraphobic.
I don't know what that means, but you gotta get outside.
Well, you're not very bright. Ha, 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 ha.
Well, how smart are you?
Real knowledge is to know the extent of one's ignorance.
Whoa, that's deep.
There's nothing for me out there. I don't fit in. I've never even been in a car.
Oh, well, you got those big legs, so walk.
Can't even fit in a house.
We'll sleep under the sky.
I'll never find a girl.
God, this is the South. We like our women big and beautiful.
But I...
You can pine your life away, wishing things were better. Waiting here for Judgment Day while hitting you a sweater. But I believe that kind of life will set your spirit free. So my friend, one small suggestion. Where do you want to be?
Everyone will tell me that he's good. son of Astrid, take with you this key to the city, and know that our doors will always be open to you.
Oh, I swear on my name, I'll never forget Astrid. I'll come back, I promise.
Chill, I'm a little late.
And people steps to an elephant, and you ask them. People want something beyond their anatomy, bigger than life. People want
you.
It's not plausible.
It's romantic. Amos Hathaway. What's your name, Brian? You got a name? It doesn't matter. Or exotic if you don't.
It's Carl.
That works. Say, Carl, have you ever considered a career in the world of entertainment? But more importantly, have you ever considered this term? Wait, what was it? Yes, an unconscionable contract.
It's an agreement in which one party grossly misrepresents the facts in order to take advantage of the other party's perceived ignorance.
Well, that's a thorough definition.
I want 30% off the top of all the food I can eat.
10%.
20. And I won't do nudity. Done. Edward, what's wrong?
Carl. Oh, I just saw the woman gonna marry. I know it. And I lost it.
Oh, heartbreaking. Most men gotta get married before they lose their wives. Oh, but good news, I'm gonna make a regular star.
Oh, that's great. At least one of us should be happy.
Jesus, kid. This girl. Real pretty, a blue dress, red hair.
But who is she? Where does she live?
Kid, don't waste your time. I know her daddy. She's out of your league.
Hey, what do you mean? You don't even know me.
Let me guess. You were the hero of Hickville, big fish in a small pond. This here is the ocean, and you're drowning. Well, take my advice, head back to Puddleville. You'll be happy with
it. Hey, look, I may not have much. But I got more determination than any man you're ever gonna meet. I'm gonna find that woman and I'm gonna marry her and spend the rest of my life with her.
Go write your Harley Quinn romance somewhere else. I got a service to run.
If you tell me who she is, I'll work night and day. And you won't even pay me.
Okay. Once a month, if you clean, if you call, if you die for me, then the clue will be true. Once a month, make the key what she thinks, what she likes, what she thinks, what she thinks, what she hopes. And all you have to do is pull the ropes. Closer to her, I'll get you closer to her. Have a few. I believe in secrets.
Wait, are you Stretch to the ever-end.
heard about. And what's the deal with Jenny Hill?
Maybe she's a friend.
Maybe she's more than that. You know, my father was a traveling salesman. He could have easily had a second life. A second family.
Oh. That's not real.
What is real with my father? What if all these crazy stories are just a smokescreen so that we don't bother looking for the truth? My father bought a secret house in Ashton. I can't just pretend we didn't find this.
Okay, I know you want to find answers. But think about the time you have left. You're here to make peace, Will, not start a war.
War? Did he tell you the war story? Because that's when I first realized he was making it all up.
Thank you. And I stormed the castles and I
let's fight the dragons and then storm the castles.
Till we win, one needs to be won. So when I'm old and tired, you'll do the drama choir. You'll be there telling stories to your son.
Superman!
Can you talk about Ashton, Dad?
I grew up there, you know that.
So why did we never visit? It's not that far a drive.
There's nothing to see there.
Look, Dad. I'm about to have a kid of my own here, and it would kill me if he went through his whole life with doubts.
It would kill, huh? All right, Will. Oh, out with it. What exactly are you accusing me of?
Dad, I'm not. I'm just trying to get a handle on some things.
Well, handle them as you will. I think we're done talking.
Dad.
Get out!
Will, what did you do?
I didn't do anything.
Calm down.
Look, I know you're trying to protect me, but you can't.
What happened?
He attacked me. He grabbed me like a bill.
I'm sure he didn't mean to. Come on, let's get you back to bed.
He's got it all wrong. I'm not the bad guy.
Like to submit one more major piece of evidence,
and then you'll acquit.
Could you kindly? face. Now you're lying.
That's enough.
You're lying right to my face.
Who is Jenny Hill?
Yeah.
Excuse me. You said you went to high school with him. Was that here in Ashton?
Well, it was in Ashton, but Ashton wasn't here. You do know what happened to the town, don't you?
No.
Oh, honey, that's the only reason your father came back. The state was building a new reservoir. The whole valley was going to be flooded. In just a few hours, the entire town of Ashton would be 30 feet underwater. Edward Bloom came back to take one last look at the town he left so long ago.
These roads are
afford to build a new town anyway.
What if I got you the land and the money?
Well, you know where to find us.
Watch out for that poisonous snake! Oh, I'm just kidding. Alright. 3, 2, 1.
Oh my god! Is that my house?
All you gotta do is sign. My wife, from the moment I saw her to the moment I die. She's the only one.
Lucky girl.
I'm sorry, Jenny.
Dr. Bennett.
Well?
Dr. Bennett, how long have you known my father?
How old are you? How many years of that?
And how would you describe him?
6'2", 190, regulated hypertension.
Can he hear us?
Hard to say what anyone hears. Harder still to know if they're listening.
I know about Ashton death. I know what you did. You saved a town and broke a girl's heart. Now, I get why you didn't want to tell Mom. I do. But what you did was heroic. I made a list of your stories. 36 basic tales with a lot of variation, of course. Some of them are jokes. Awful jokes, mostly. You take the rest at it, it's like a myth. A small town farmer's son from Alabama who wanted to see the world. But you didn't, Dad. I did. And I think that's because of you. All this time I thought you were trying to impress me. You were trying to inspire me. Dad, do you want me to get a nurse? Well, what can I do? Can I get you something? Water?
The river. Tell me how it happens.
How what happens?
How I go.
I don't. Wait, you mean what the witch showed you? I don't know what you saw. You never told me that part of the story.
Oh, well.
I don't know how to do this, Dad. Look, I can try. I can try, okay? Just tell me how it starts.
Like this.
Okay. First things first. You're in this prison cell. You have to find a way to break out. Find another place to stay out. Look around. Be sure we haven't seen. Slowly check the door before we're spotted. I know.
There at the river.
but I thank you all for coming. A man is as rich as his friends. I'm a tycoon. But there's something missing here.
Control.
Oh.
And faith.
truck.
Oh, yeah, I chucked him. We're gonna catch it. Oh, I can't wait. I want to see this fish. You boys get hungry, there's barbecue.
You know, it was right here on this spot where your granddad helped me catch my first fish. It was this big.